Most Android flagships have eliminated the notch, using less-intrusive, hole-punch camera designs instead. But the iPhone still has one, even 4 years after its debut in 2017, and I'll explain why right now. So the biggest reason why the iPhone still needs a notch is because it houses some vital components, like the flood illuminator, dot projector, and infrared camera. This is in addition to the selfie camera, speaker, and microphone that exists on virtually every smartphone. That means Apple doesn't have much of a choice. A notch is the most seamless design solution available. If they took the hole punch approach, there'd be a handful of seemingly random cutouts at the top of the display, which would not only look bad, but also fail to add any real functionality. In fact, Apple stopped including white bezels on iPhones due to how unsightly the black sensors would look. But why does the iPhone need all these sensors anyway? Well, they make up the TrueDepth camera system that powers Face ID, allowing you to unlock your phone with facial recognition. And although Android phones like the Samsung Galaxy also have this feature, it's implemented in a completely different way. Apple uses 3D facial mapping technology, which requires an array of sensors, while Samsung's 2D mapping only needs one camera lens. The problem is, Samsung's approach is much less secure and convenient, being easily fooled by photos and videos of someone's face while also taking longer to register. And it's important for the iPhone's facial recognition system to perform exceptionally, since it's the only form of biometric security available, whereas Samsung offers an in-screen fingerprint scanner, allowing users to opt out of facial recognition completely and removing the need for a large notch. Now, with the iPhone 13, Apple did shrink the notch by 20%, but it's still more intrusive than a single hole-punch camera, and there are rumors that Apple may adopt in-screen fingerprint scanners in the future once the technology matures enough to meet their standards, which could finally allow for a notchless iPhone. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.